Why does the West End matter, and what makes the Olivier such an important celebration?
The West End only matters if it's putting on content that matters. At the moment, I'm in a theatre that I think is putting content on that matters. So for me, my part of the West End right now matters. It's got to be entertaining. It doesn't always have to be politically irrelevant. It doesn't have to do all those things. But as a whole, the West End has to satisfy all those demands throughout different parts of it, you know what I mean? And I think it's doing that really well at the moment. The thing that I don't know if it's doing it, it probably is doing it, but I always think like any business, like any product, you've always got to keep reaching out to the new people that are going to be buying your product, to speak like a businessman for a second. And I just hope that theatre is doing that and really properly reaching out to younger people. Not just because the youth are tomorrow and all that, which you always hear. I'm not one of those people that go on about the youth all the time. But the you know, audiences will dry up and they'll just flock to movies if we don't. But I think, you know, I'm not scathing. I think theatre may be doing that, so it's good.
How satisfying is it, not only for you to be nominated, but to be nominated for a piece like The Ruling Class that, like you say, tackles such interesting issues?
Yeah, and also it's just dead funny. This is the most important thing to me. It is dead important. It's also, it was a huge risk doing The Ruling Class. It's not been put on since 1968 for a reason. It's one of the most difficult things to put on, I think, you could ever imagine. And I've got so much admiration for Jamie Lloyd for not just having the guts and the cojones to put it on, but to actually pull it off with such aplomb and bravura. He's a special director, and he's as much tied into everything I've done in theatre as anything else. So it is, just to do something that risky on Whitehall, in the West End, in commercial theatre, not in subsidised theatre, and get away with it. I've got so much respect and admiration for him, and he is what I think the future of theatre needs, you know, and what I think it's getting actually as well. Lots of people like him who take big, bold risks in places that are potentially and perceived anyway as being safe, like the West End. Not being safe in those environments is, I think, what tomorrow's audience want. They want something that is risky and edgy.
I mean, obviously, you're such an eclectic performer, working a lot of different medium. What's the one thing, the essence, that you're always looking for when you look at a project?
Risk, really. I'm always looking for something that's going to stretch me as a performer and a storyteller and teach me something. You learn whatever you are, but you'll learn more on certain things. And the riskier the project, the harder it's going to be, the harder it is, the more you're going to have to pull out the bag to pull it off and do some pretty heavy lifting. So, yeah, I'm always looking to do some heavy lifting, really.